Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Frying Pan, your favorite pop culture podcast. It's me, your host, Daniel Rocketeer Sear, and I'm here with my good friend.
It's me, his good friend, Robert Blackberry D'Onofrio. How's it going, folks? I feel like my voice always slightly cracks when I do my name for some reason. I don't know why.
We like to keep things consistent here, so it's probably for the best that you just keep going with it, you know, man?
Yeah, for real though.
All right. Anywho, hey.
How
No.
any who
No.
I? Any
How are
who
you
I?
doing?
How am I? Oof, no, how are you? No, I insist, Dan.
No. I
How are
insist.
you?
You first.
All right, I'm not gonna go through this again, so I'll go.
Good.
I'm good. I went and spent the night at my brother's house last night, which is really nice. He's a pretty chill guy. We hung out, watched some movies and shit, played some video games, had a nice time, listened to music. It was nice, chill. You would know from my Snapchat story that I was fucking around with the neighbor's goats who are like super chill and friendly.
You might want to
They
clarify that fucking around the ghost just means petting them and not actually being a nuisance.
Well, yeah, of course. They were just super nice and just like, hey, it's a person. Come say hi. Because every time I'd walk away, they would just kind of like yell at me collectively. Like there was like at least like 12 of them. And they would just start yelling if I walked away without petting them for long enough.
Well, very
It
cute.
was,
Glad you had a good time.
yeah. Yeah, it was nice. And then today's Tuesday, as you know. So here we are. How about yourself? How do you find yourself today and yesterday?
My past 2 days have been pretty shitty, I'm gonna be honest, but it's okay because we pushed through it.
I know you haven't talked to me that much in the last 2 days, so it must be devastating.
Well, it really was devastating when I didn't hear from you yesterday. I just was kind of lost. I didn't know what to do with myself. But no, we're finding our way. I don't know, nothing really interesting on my half. Just kind of going with the motion. One thing is, I think I'm gonna start streaming again. Maybe get into that.
Streaming.
Yeah.
Interesting. What game in particular made you want to think about it?
Twitch.tv forward slash I am Dolol, in case you're interested in popping by. Nothing in general. I was just, because I did yesterday, I played some League of Legends with Alex, and I had a lot of fun. And a couple old friends popped into the chat, said hello, and we talked. It was a good time. It's always fun.
Nice-o.
Yeah. But other than that, nothing
Nice.
interesting. Oh, actually, the other interesting thing was
Oh.
you, me, and our good friend Jordan went to go see the new Godzilla movie. Gonna preface it with we were a little under the influence. We were safe driving, don't worry. But anywho, saw the
I
new
was
Godzilla.
smacked, my
Yeah,
guy.
saw the new Godzilla movie. Let me tell you, they really never. You know what you're gonna get when you see like a Godzilla movie? Like you come to
You
see,
should.
yeah,
Yeah, you should.
you come to see Godzilla, and that's about it. But you never take into fact or take into consideration that they never improve the acting whatsoever. And it's not like, obviously, like acting is a skill, and it takes it takes time to hone that craft. But like we had pretty recognizable actors that are good actors, and it's as if like the director was just like, all right, throw everything out the window. Just be there.
Yeah, for real. Like they just one take the whole movie.
Honestly, they probably did. They very well could have. Or maybe the budget just didn't, the budget was all in the CGI and they couldn't afford more lines.
Understandable because the CGI was the one good thing about the movie. I guess the soundtrack was pretty good during the fights, but the CGI, man, was satisfying.
Yeah.
Very satisfying.
Yeah, unlike the previous Godzilla, we got to see him for more than 4 minutes of screen time. He was pretty
Oh
prominent.
yeah. We got to see a decent bit of the big boy. He fought more than one time throughout the movie as well.
Yeah, he was beefing. I want to talk about it. I'm gonna spoil it because it's a Godzilla movie. If you're that curious about the plot, there's something wrong with you.
Yeah, honestly, just kind of fuck off at that point. I'm sorry. Like, I
honestly.
don't mean to sound like an asshole, but like, you're not in it for the story. Who you clowning?
You're coming for monsters to fucking Batista bomb each other, not for what Cassandra has to say. But
Yeah, if you didn't piece it together from the trailer, then you're nutty.
yeah, but We got Godzilla, and then we got King Ghidorah. King Ghidorah, the bad guy, apparently not from Earth. I don't. I. It was just random, and like the whole. All right. So the main thing that I found hilarious was there's an organization that's like, we got to befriend the monsters and, let them reign free. And then you have like the military that's like, oh, we gotta fucking kill them. And then there's this third group that also wants to like let the monsters be free, but I guess in the Godzilla universe, all of them used to be gods, hence Godzilla, you know what I'm saying? But it's weird because the organization, like, I don't know, they just come in and fucking kill each other, and it had no meaning to the story just to kill people or to set up like a twist towards the end that had no relevancy. And you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I feel you.
I don't.
I mean, it
Sorry.
was
You
it
go.
tried to they tried to give it a complex plot. Nothing else but that, man.
It's
I
just.
mean, you're spot on. Like, there was no reason. Like, it didn't feel natural at all.
Yeah, I just have such a hard time explaining it because it literally made no sense. But,
Oh, no, not at all.
anywho, the other part that I thought was hilarious was that apparently Mothra and Godzilla are in a relationship.
Oh, okay. So the thing is, they did say I think they said symbiotic, which if I'm remembering back to 8th grade science, it's like where they are in a relationship, but not like a romantic relationship. It's simply like these two organisms benefit off each other.
That makes sense.
So,
But
like, essentially, the radiation from her wings was like feeds Godzilla.
that was something else that I found weird is like end of the movie, Mothra suicide bombs into King Ghidorah to explode and like all little pixie dust rains down on Godzilla, and then when Godzilla starts walking, like everything around him just melts.
Well, that was the thing. They had a callback, if you remember. They're like, it was like so random. They're like, his temperatures are rising. Everyone's like, huh? Yeah, he's going supernova. It's
Yeah,
like, why?
and then he nukes Boston, and then the mother scientist lady can, like, later on in the movie, she can easily survive, and then she just dies because she wants to.
Yeah. She just like yeets the. Th or I don't even know, because I guess like throwing the little sound. Honestly, watch the movie, because even though we're chalking out to be pretty shit, it's still kind of a worth watch if you can stomach it.
I would recommend being under some form of alcohol or
The
marijuana
Frying Pan Podcast does not
legally.
condone drug or alcohol use.
Legally, in
Yeah,
moderation,
legally. Yeah.
enough to make the
Yeah, we're
movie
all.
more enjoyable. How about
Enough to make you not want to get up and leave.
that? But that's the thing. Like, even if I was completely sober, I don't think I would have got up and leave. But I was just, it was.
I would have pulled out my phone during the movie. I'm not even one of those kind of people who's ever done that, but I probably would have during this movie.
Yeah, I can understand that. But that's your Godzilla recap. What are you gonna give it out of 10, Bobby?
Okay, hold on, real quick. I figured out why I had such a problem with how you said King Ghidorah.
Why?
Because, excuse me, you don't enunciate. So to me, it sounds like you're saying Kinky Dora.
That's just unsettling, and
Yeah,
I'm sorry.
that's what I've been hearing this whole time. It's just Kinky Dora.
King Ghidorah. That's that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Anywho, yeah, what do
Sorry.
you give it out of 10?
What if, gosh, my enjoyment level or actual comparing it to other
How
movies?
about as an actual film?
Could it be like it's probably like a five that has one or two good points that could have been eights on their own?
Yeah, I'll give it a 6.
Yeah, I would say like averaging out would probably be like 5.56, but like the CGI was like the only thing that made that worthwhile to me. Like, it wasn't even the best CGI, but then again, like, they're giant monsters that like tower, like, of course they're not gonna, look that quote quote realistic.
Yeah, I'd say they did the best they could. But
Yeah.
anyways, you wanna jump into some topics?
I'll jump into some topics if you're giving me first at bat.
Yeah, if you wanna step up to the plate, you're more than welcome.
Step up to the plate. All right. I was trying to think of what they call like the batter's mound in like cricket for some reason, but honestly I don't even know
the batter's
what it's called.
box. They call it a batter's box.
No, I meant like the plate. Like, what do they call like the first mound or whatever?
Pitcher's mound.
You're not getting what I'm talking about, so I'm just gonna move on.
Okay, you can explain to me later.
I'll explain to you. I'll text you at 3 a.m.
Okay, cool.
So, in my never-ending quest to inform our listeners and just talk about environmental stuff that's going on, because I like to, as I was telling you before the podcast, I like to find the stuff that's kind of uplifting, just so, like, I feel like the news and ads online only post the bad stuff. I'm definitely not denying that we are hell-bent on a track that could completely fuck our planet, but there is some improvements being made here and there, and I like to draw attention to those, because, you know, it's nice to actually think, like, there is something positively going on in that aspect, and it's not all just a downward hill plunge or whatever.
I got you.
So, with that, Dunkin', previously known as Dunkin' Donuts, just remember that was a thing, is ditching their foam cups by the end of the year. So, this has gone to effect in New York City, California, Hawaii, Pennsylvania, Ohio, West Virginia, Michigan, Kentucky, and India, and a decent bit of cities in Massachusetts. And I'm not sure as of right now, but they plan, you know, to keep going this with other, about 9,000 other locations in the U.S. And I think this is a really cool thing because it, like, they kind of, like, Dunkin's kind of thing is, like, people like their styrofoam cups. They like being able to, like, drop an iced coffee in a styrofoam cup. Or, like, the double cup thing, or, you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Like, that's kind of, like, was Dunkin's thing, why, like, people still like Dunkin' Donuts coffee. They know it's pretty average, you know?
Yeah.
It sounds dumb, but apparently in projections, that's a big reason why people went there. Anyways, they said, screw it, we don't care, and they went forward with it, and they're just coming out with, sustainable forestry initiative standard cups, as they say, and they'll come in small, medium, large, and extra large sizes.
Okay.
And they're double-walled paper cups. They should, you know, keep it well insulated, just like, you know, the foam ones. You know, they should function pretty much the same. But they're doing it in the name of environmental conservation, which is pretty sweet.
Very cool.
Very cool.
Double-walled paper cups. What if it was literally just like they ripped two pieces of white line paper out of a notebook and they turned them into cups?
Well, I don't think that would. I don't think that would hold some coffee, Dan.
Oh.
I think there's a hole in your what if there.
I'm just trying to be optimistic here. You know what I'm saying?
That's optimistic.
Maybe to somebody, but no, I'm on board with this. I'm happy that Dunkin' is, you know, taking steps.
Yeah. I'm interested to see what they look like, though. I wonder if they're just going to look, you know, the same as the styrofoam ones did, with just the logo on the side. I wonder if they do, like, a different designs and stuff now.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like they will probably just keep the same kind of simple, classic design, because that's what people are accustomed to, and some people just don't like change like that, you know?
I always wish, like, companies did, like, I wouldn't say monthly, maybe, like, bi-monthly cup designs or something.
I mean, Starbucks does that from time to time, but it's just based, like, around holidays.
Mm.
Like, they got their red cup for Christmas.
Mm. I guess I would see as, like, as a, like, coffee consumer, like, it'd just be, like, a nice little thing to smile about sometime. I don't know, maybe if I get rich and buy a coffee franchise, I might just do that.
Hey, I mean, it's always been my dream to open a coffee shop when I'm older. I see that, what you said has got me thinking, what if they did, like, a contest where you could like send in a design and each month they'll like pick different ones that they like the best.
Ooh, kind of like what Google does once a year or so.
Yeah, what Google does with just their Google, you know?
Yeah, their logo.
Yeah.
Logo.
I don't know how to say their logo. Like when you go onto Google, it just, fuck it, whatever. I'm going to start a petition to get Dunkin' to start doing that so that they're a little more likable.
Honestly, let's get it going on Twitter. Retweet it.
Maybe up the quality of the coffee a bit. I'm not one to drink coffee, but I've heard Dunkin' Donuts coffee just tastes like mud.
I think it's okay. I think it's made improvements. It's like, I feel like it's each day it's different, just like any other place.
Yeah, I mean, that's fair. But, yeah.
In other environmental news, something more positive and a little quick thing. It's just a little haha, yay. The New York City shores have been flooded with whales, and experts think they know why. This is a positive. They're not washing up.
Okay, see, you just put the headline in for me in the doc, and I was really confused on why you were saying this is a good thing.
Yeah. So essentially, what it is there is cleaner water. That doesn't sound about right, given the talk we hear on, the news and stuff. But there is. And this has led to a 540% increase in their numbers in just the last 8 years, because the water's been improving.
Okay.
So essentially, staggering numbers of whales have been sighted because of this. And this is believed to be wise, because there's cleaner water.
Hey.
Or rather, it's been more cleaning up, the water's been more thorough.
That's good. Very good to hear. Was it, do you know if it was something like whales used to be here a lot and then they migrated away due to it not being clean and now they're migrating back, or is it just, is it a new thing?
Well, they think it's because the increase in nutrients in the water, because it is cleaner, has led to more algae growth, which attracts more types of fish, and then a bigger food source will then move in for those, and then the whales come as well with that. So essentially, it's just because the ecosystem overall just improved.
Okay, very cool. I don't know if you know the answer to this, but do you know what benefits whales bring to the ecosystem? Or is it just that they're there?
It's kind of like a predatory advantage. So, like, I know in some cases it's similar to like how even like spiders are beneficial. Like, you may not think they are, but like just them killing, like killing off some of the, the pesky normal stuff makes it so it doesn't get out of control, pretty much.
That's true.
In some cases,
Yeah, no, I can see that.
like if you were to ask me about killer whales, I don't know, it'd be fucking assholes to seals.
Yeah, I killer whales are cool, but they're not very. Well, I guess I you could say that about anything of like everything has a benefit to the ecosystem, like
Yeah,
predators
in its
killing
own way.
prey leads to not overpopulation, all that jazz.
It's just a cog in the ecosystem,
Yeah, it's weird to think
Big or small.
that's kind of just how like the ecosystem is. It's just like a giant, well-oiled machine.
Yeah, really. And then, when we fuck up the environment, that fucks up that machine.
It's literally like the environment is just a nice running machine, and then someone just throws like 90 wrenches at it, and that's us. We're the wrenches.
We gotta stop throwing wrenches, people.
It's
Switch
dangerous.
off of plastic bags. Buy reusable.
Guys, stop throwing wrenches. It's dangerous. They're heavy. They're made of metal. They can really hurt you. It's not safe.
Yeah.
Guys.
And honestly, the only time you should be throwing wrenches is if you're trying to teach yourself how to dodge a ball.
Well, that's true. If you can dodge a ball, or if you can dodge a wrench, you can dodge a ball.
Yeah, it's the only time you're allowed to throw wrenches.
This is
That's
kind of off topic, but
what I
kind of on
thought.
topic. We should find one of those places where you can throw axes at the targets. You know what I'm talking about?
I knew what you were talking about right away, but I for some reason thought at the other end of throw axes, I thought there was going to be an at each other for some reason.
Maybe a few years down the road when we're really sick of each other. But no, because they have like the they're kind of like shooting ranges, but instead of like shooting guns,
Yeah,
you throw axes at the
they're like,
targets.
yeah, throw like axes, knives. Yeah, I would agree. I know when the Renaissance fairs come around, we can go to those and do those.
Ooh, that'd be interesting. I'd be around for that. See,
I would as well.
the other thing I would like to get our friends group into, but I don't think it'd happen, is rock climbing.
Rock climbing.
Nah, but it's like the only thing with rock climbing is it's an expensive hobby, but it is a really good workout.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's kind of off
Couldn't
topic.
you couldn't get me in that one, I'm
No,
sorry.
that's fine. Well, that's what I'm saying, 'cause it's very like niche and a lot of effort and money for something that you kind of have to be committed to.
I don't even think I would be able to build up the hand strength through rock climbing.
Yeah, I feel that.
Like, those guys are crazy. Have you ever shook like a rock climber's hand?
Yeah, they can fucking break your hand with one grip.
It's crazy, man.
It's crazy.
But that wraps up Wales. Just a little positive.
Yeah. Well, speaking of climbing mountains and occasionally falling off, this one you probably don't know about, but there was a YouTube channel called Sugar Pine 7 that they started making videos like 2-3 years ago, and I remember watching them from the beginning. And I used to watch like every video for the first 2 years, and then they kind of fell off with the content. They tried to do too much, you know what I mean? And it just didn't stick.
Mm-hmm.
But they recently got dropped by their like parent company, and they are just kind of splitting up, and the whole channel is just dying, or is like dead at this point. And they released like a final video, and it was very sad, very depressing, but it made me appreciate what I watched a lot more.
Oh, that's sad.
Yeah. But it consists of three nice boys and a bunch of people to help them along the way. I would recommend, like, if you've never watched a video, to at least look it up and watch some older videos, because they're very entertaining, and some of them are, like, really cinematically, like, executed very well.
Mm-hmm.
And they made, like, a short movie, too, a couple of years ago that I don't know if it did well, but it was definitely interesting to watch.
All right. I'll definitely give it a shot. Probably. Yeah, it sounds interesting.
Thank you. Just give it a try for me. But, just wanted to give a little shout out to them. I hope they, find their way.
Hope they find their way.
Yeah. But it was leading me into, something I wanted to ask you. Has there ever been something that like, you've watched for a very long time and to see it come to an end?
On YouTube?
You could do YouTube or just something else. Like, obviously, like, Game of Thrones could be an example, but...
Okay. There's definitely a book series I've done that with.
Hold on. Let me reword that. Instead of, like, come to an end, like, kind of just got canceled.
Got canceled. Okay.
Yeah.
Hmm. There was an anime I really liked, and it was very good. It got a second season, and everyone loved it. And then news came out that the whole show was just supposed to be a advertisement for the light novel. I think you know the show I'm talking about already.
I do know the show you're talking about, and I can definitely agree that I was also very upset when they didn't do, like, a third season.
And, like, it felt like it got canceled because, like, the show definitely did super well. Like, super, super well. Everyone loved it. But it was just only an advertisement for the book it was based off of. And it was just so depressing because they were like, yeah, no third season planned. Sorry.
Yeah, that was a real tragedy because, well, if anybody wants to look up the show we're talking about, it's called Konosuba.
Yeah.
If you're a big weeb. But, bottom line,
if you're a weeb, it's pretty freaking funny regardless.
Yeah, even if you don't watch anime, it's definitely funny. Like, I don't think there was actually a bad episode in the two seasons that it aired. I definitely enjoyed, like, basically every minute I watched.
Yeah, it was just lighthearted comedy that made you feel good.
Yeah. And then it was like second season ended, and then everyone was like, there's no way they don't make a third, right? It was really good. And they said they weren't even going to make a second one, if I remember correctly.
Mm. Yep.
And they
came out with that bullshit, so that was pretty depressing.
Yeah, it was very depressing, to be honest.
Yeah, so, you know, moving on from that now painful question. Ow, reliving past scars. Thanks, Dan.
You know me. But shout out Sugar Pine.
Share down below.
Shout out what? Them. Shout out for the joy and the laughs you brought.
Yeah.
I don't know what they're going to do from here on out. So it's just kind of, they made the video and it ended very kind of open-ended, but like very concrete, if that makes any sense.
So it was a goodbye video, but like maybe a goodbye video with a new beginning somewhere along the line?
No. It could, it's like a 3-minute video. I'd recommend you watch it, even if you don't know. But, it was kind of, it ended, like, very depressing, as in, like, we have no idea what we're going to do. But they still do a podcast.
Mm-hmm.
So they talk about it there. But it's just not the same as it was, and they all recognize that.
Oh, that's very, very sad.
Yeah. But it was also, I don't know. It's nice because now they're all probably going to go explore their own options, so hopefully it works out for them.
Interesting.
Also, speaking of exploring options, George R. R. Martin is working with from Soft Games, a game developer company. Fuck, I can't talk.
He's emotional, folks. Go check out Sugar Pine 7 and support them.
Thank you. George R. R. Martin and FromSoft Game have been hinting that they're going to make a game together. And you know about this.
So, the thing that I find very interesting, right? So, besides E3 being next week, so hopefully we'll be able to talk about E3 in our next episode, but the thing is they're explicitly saying in this article that they're going for a Souls-like game, right? And George R.R. Martin isn't a, like, he's a writer, you know? Like, he writes. So I'm thinking, like, if this is a Souls-like game, it's gotta be on, like, the lines of Sekiro in terms of, like, it's a story game, not like Bloodborne or Dark Souls, where there's a loose story that you have to kind of work for.
Yeah,
You know
that's
what I mean?
true. There was somebody that made a video about it. I think the game is either called Grand Rune or Great Rune.
I think
And
it's Great Rune.
I think it's Great Rune too, yeah. But it was hinted, like a lot of speculation, that they want to make like an open world story game. And yeah, like you said, they want to make like a Souls-like game because FromSoft is known for making Dark Souls. Very popular game.
Says there's horse riding in it.
I'm seeing that, but I'm trying to think, because even if he doesn't make like a story, like a game like Sekiro, where the story is very defined and you have to follow this path, whereas like say Dark Souls or Bloodborne, you're just going through killing shit and that's the main premise, and then the story kind of comes after, like the lore. I think he would still do a really good job of creating lore for a new universe.
See, I agree, but the thing is, it says he's only been he's kind of been consulting with them. Like, he doesn't really come out and say he's had a huge part in the project, you know? So I'm like trying to think of like why it would be important, like what that he is even there, you know what I mean? Like what's the big deal? Like why would they go as far as to hire this guy? 'Cause he's got to be expensive to have on the team, right?
Yeah, but you got to think he also definitely knows what he's talking about when it comes to world building and storytelling with
Well,
all of Game
so
of
like you,
Thrones.
yeah, but still, but so people like on the Witcher team and like the Elder Scrolls team, you know, the point I'm trying to make is why go through the trouble of going for a big author like this? So that makes me think maybe it's like a Witcher style game in terms of like story, but it's set in almost like a George R. R. Martin universe.
Yeah, I could definitely see that. I mean, I also think it's that he just wanted to work on it, not that they necessarily like had to pay out the ass to get him, you know what I mean?
I guess that's kind of where I struggle, 'cause like if he is just fucking helping out for fun, write the damn book, okay?
Now you just seem like you're viewing from the perspective of someone that's mad that he hasn't finished the Game of Thrones book.
Hey, I'm trying to be optimistic because if he's just fucking dicking around with this and he doesn't even play a decent part in it, fuck you, dude. Come on, give me the last book.
Jesus, you sound like an
Just give
awful
it.
I was gonna say you sound like an awful person.
I just need closure from the show, man. We
Yep.
discussed Game of Thrones enough, but I just need closure.
I understand. I think everybody's on the same page. But it's also like, if it's something he's passionate about and he's like very on board with this, then hey.
Yeah, I just want to see what he can do in terms of like game story, because I know another one of my favorite authors, Patrick Rothfuss, has put his fingers in some video games, and that's a very weird way to phrase it, has dabbled in writing for games, and he's done a really great job, so
Yeah.
I would like to see that kind of normalize a little bit, like authors being a part of other types of projects
Yeah, I feel like it's
like
not a
this.
hard thing to transition from, like, into. You know what I mean?
Well, it's kind of because like video games and story games, they have their own writers, you know. It's kind of a little bit unfair for an author to use their like status as a known author to kind of take those job opportunities from other definitely well-qualified artists just without that well-known name, you know.
No, I understand that. I'm just saying it, that like making a book is probably pretty similar to making the story for a video game.
Oh,
Not
most
that he's
definitely, but
taking away jobs.
No. Yeah, I mean, I imagine if they do bring on like an A-list writer or something, like I imagine they give them one section of the story. You know, like you write this portion. You know, like this is where how you get here. Now you write from here to there, and another person will take up from there. I imagine that's how games are written.
Yeah, I wouldn't think that it's just one person running the gauntlet on a game.
Yeah, I feel like that'd be a lot of angles to work out on your own.
Yeah, also it'd be hard to not have like other perspectives to help guide you to where you think you want to get to.
Oh, I'm sure there's like directors and stuff still, but even then, just like their artistic whereabouts because there's so many parameters.
Well, yeah, exactly. But nonetheless, E3, I guess we're gonna hear about it June 9th, hopefully. That's when
I
Microsoft
can't
press
wait for E3.
conferences says. But yeah, definitely looking forward to it. Yeah, we'll probably.
Published by Bandai Namco, by the way.
Oh yeah?
Yeah,
Oh,
it's
okay.
going to be, yeah.
I can get behind that. But yeah, I definitely want to talk about E3 next podcast though, hopefully. Maybe not the
All
whole
right.
time, but yeah, just keep in mind, just so people know.
Already right. Already.
But speaking in the realms of entertainment, Netflix and the Russo brothers are going to make a Magic the Gathering animated series. Now,
See, okay.
hit me.
I was gonna ask, what do you think about that?
I never played like Magic the Gathering, the card game, but
I've tried it.
I remember seeing it, and I was like, me playing Yu-Gi-Oh! I was like, even this looks too dorky for me.
See, I thought the same thing, but I also it was accompanied by this is way too complicated for me.
That too, yeah. Because Yu-Gi-Oh! Is pretty easy to figure out. Just read the card and like, oh, my attack is more than your defense. I kill you. Like that. But
Yeah.
Magic the Gathering was like carry the three divided by seven. It's not going to make any sense. I win. Something like that.
I don't even know,
Yeah.
man.
Okay, while we're on the
There.
topic, do you remember the fucking Pokemon card game that made literally no sense?
I'm gonna be honest, bro. I don't even think that game was possible to actually play.
They gave you a number and they just it the descriptions didn't tell you like what be what or anything of that nature. It was like, yeah, flip a coin.
I mean, like, yeah. It's just, I don't know what the hell you do. I never even understood it,
Yeah.
ever.
But regardless, Magic the Gathering, a card game being adapted into an animated series by the Russo brothers, which
Well,
they What movie did they do, Bobby? Ooh.
it was kind of underground. I think it was the Avengers Infinity War and Avengers Endgame that they directed.
Yeah, it
I
was.
don't know. It was pretty underground.
Yeah, Avengers Infinity War was a straight to Netflix movie. Not a lot of people heard about it.
Oh, you're
Endgame
right.
was underground. You had the Pirate Bay that otherwise probably didn't see it.
Yeah.
Anywho. They're
Yeah.
pretty important. They're pretty big when it comes to making movies. So, I don't know. I'm definitely interested to see how it turns out because I don't know if you saw the Castlevania animated series. Do you watch that at all?
What?
Yeah.
No.
On Netflix, there's a Castlevania animated series. I would recommend you watch it. I think it's like,
Is it? It's good.
yeah, it's like six episode seasons. They're very good. It's definitely worth a watch, I'd say.
Interesting. Now, I guess I'm pretty okay with them just doing it, 'cause I mean, I doubt they're gonna make it like a card game, right? Like they're not gonna, like, what if it's just like Yu-Gi-Oh, but
Okay.
Magic the Gathering? Like that would make me off myself. I'm not gonna lie to you.
Are you serious? I would be okay with that. I think I
If
wouldn't
they
mind
just
it.
totally just they just made the characters play the game, that's such like a dumb plot. I feel like that's just a boring plot idea rather.
Well, I mean, how did you feel about like the Yu-Gi-Oh anime when you were a kid?
Well, that's the thing. I thought it was cool as shit when I was a kid, but I mean, like, this is Magic the Gathering. No one's looking at Magic the Gathering cards unless they've freaking already wasted thousands of dollars on them over the past 12 fucking years.
You know, that's true. I feel like the people that are excited for a Magic the Gathering series are probably already in their late 30s.
Yeah, like I mean, not even trying to like make these people feel bad for liking what they like. It's just like I'm of the opinion that if you are into Magic the Gathering, you're set. Like I feel like there's no people that are like, eh, yeah, I dabble in magic. Like no, you're probably just in it.
Yeah, you're definitely like committed. 100%. 100%.
Or at least that's how the community makes it seem, just because it's such an expensive hobby. But that's besides the point. For the show, I feel like even if they just like tap into all the lore, I think it could be just cool in general.
Yeah. Well, that was the thing. I didn't get too much into Magic the Gathering as a kid, obviously. But I definitely looked at some of the cards, and they did look cool, to their credit.
Yeah. Well, I wonder, like, if the Russo brothers are working on this, like, I wonder what the budget's like for the series, you know?
That's true. I mean, they definitely have a few Benjamins to spare.
Yeah, but, like, I'm trying to be like, is it... I wonder if it's going to be... Is it... You said animated, right?
Yep.
I wonder if it's going to be, like, CGI animated, you know, like, Devil Cry Baby, whatever the fuck it is.
Oh, Devil May Cry Baby?
Yeah, some shit. I think it just might be Devil Cry Baby.
No, it's Devil May Cry Baby.
Okay. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about, yeah. But I wonder if they're going to do it like full CGI, is the point I'm trying to get at. Because Netflix does seem to like CGI stuff.
Yeah, they do love CGI. I kind of hope not. I kind of hope it's just mellow, like a casual animated series. I don't know. I don't like when like 2D stuff bring in 3D aspects. I think it just throws it off.
I mean, I just haven't found a CGI movie that I've liked yet.
Oh, yeah. Well, Godzilla.
I guess.
All right, honestly,
that wasn't a movie without it.
Okay, really quick to rant about Godzilla one last time. There's a part where he picks up King Ghidorah and he, like, fucking seismic tosses it. And he never does it again. For the rest of the movie, he just kind of, like, strangles the two heads. And then the third one bites him and then he lets go. That's all I have to say. I'm sorry. That was my last rant.
Dan just wanted to see the monsters do pro wrestling moves on each other.
I fucking did! I'm like, there's no reason he can't!
I mean, true. I mean, I would have lost my shit if he just freaking, like, turned around and pile drove
him. Well, there's, like, the 19-some-whatever Godzilla, like, one of the first ones, there's the scene where he fucking, like, drop kicks another monster. And I'm like, that would have been so great at this CGI.
Wait. Just running jump, just boom.
Yeah, literally. Except it's poorly done, so it looks terrible. But maybe in today's age, it would look fine.
Or maybe it still looks terrible, and that's why they didn't put it in.
Very true. But sorry, off topic. My Godzilla rant over. 6 out of 10. Okay. Whatever.
Right. Yeah. Netflix.
Netflix Magic the Gathering. Apparently, they were huge fans of the card game growing up, though. So that's kind of interesting.
I mean, I believe.
Okay, they did say they want to be able to bring the stories to life through animation.
Okay, that's interesting. Well, you know, I guess I'll have... This is one of the ones that I'll actually have... Like, I'll say I'll give shows a watch all the time on Netflix. I never do. I'll probably have to just because the Russo brothers have a part in it.
Wait a minute. You know who's involved in this?
Who's that?
The lead writer for the Star Wars The Clone Wars series.
Wait a minute.
Yeah.
The show could actually be pretty freaking good.
That's another show.
It says this series will cross the genres of suspenseful, thriller, horror, and drama with deeply developed characters that likes which are not often seen in animation.
That is a...
That's a tall order. I don't know if...
I couldn't think of the word.
Thank you. That?
Yeah, that's ambitious to say. I hope you live up to it, but that's a lot. I'll be honest.
I mean, hey, I would believe it if they're like help funding this project. I would definitely believe it.
That's true. Yeah, if they put in a lot of effort to it, then I could definitely see it.
It's definitely feasible. I guess we'll have to wait and see. But speaking of someone that's a big fan of a franchise, I guess Drake popped off at the finals.
Oh yeah.
Basketball.
I know you're not huge.
I'm struggling here because I'm not a very big basketball person.
Yep.
As you know.
And well, you don't have to be a basketball fan to know who Drake is. Pretty big guy.
Who?
Aubrey Graham. He was on Degrassi. He was Wheelchair Jimmy. You remember him?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm glad. You all right? Did that bring back bad memories?
I'm sorry. No, just how like candid you were with that.
Well, you didn't know who Drake was. I figured you'd know him for his more popular role. Jeez. But Yeah, Drake, this playoffs has been kind of obnoxious, but very entertaining to watch, I'd say. Raptors, they're in the finals now. They walk their way through. A lot of gifs, a lot of pictures. There's one incident that I thought was great that happened in the Eastern Conference Finals between the Milwaukee Bucks and the Raptors. Milwaukee Bucks owner's daughter was at the game, and it was like after the game, the Bucks lost, and then Drake changed his picture to her profile picture, and then just trolled the family. It's very weird. He's just a weird dude, but he's enjoying himself.
I mean, he was popping off in all the pictures and gifs I've seen.
Oh yeah, there's another one where he just starts giving the head coach a back massage.
Jeez, it looks like he's trying to fight the other team.
Oh yeah, a little bit. Let's see. Finals. He's been wearing a lot of different clothes to troll the players. Like game one of the finals, he wore Steph Curry's dad's jersey when he, because his dad used to play for the Raptors, you know. And he's like just screaming at the Warriors players when they walk by. It's actually just like he's into it, and I gotta respect it.
Did the Raptors win or lose?
Series tied 1-1. Raptors won game one, then the Warriors won game two. But the other thing that was funny is he wore a like a Home Alone sweatshirt to troll one of the players on the other team. But Macaulay Culkin was actually in the stands behind him.
Are you serious?
Yeah, and he tweeted him. He's like, "Hey Drake, I'm right here. DM me." Don't know.
Jesus.
Yeah, just what he's trying to be the sixth man of the year. He's trying to be.
He's so happy.
I know, that's my favorite thing is he's so into it. And just, hey man, live your best life. That's also because like Toronto as a basketball team normally doesn't win anything.
I'm sorry, I'm just reading some of these guys' tweets at it, and one of these guys goes, just time to just give him assistant coach or hype man or something and be done with it, because no one, like everyone on the court is just okay with it.
Yeah, they're so with it. It's, I don't know, it's crazy. I love watching it though. So keep doing your thing, Drake. And if you ever want to come on the podcast, you have my number. Just text me. Drake does
I was
not.
gonna make a bad joke.
What
Never
was
mind.
the joke?
It was gonna be a freaking one dance line.
Yeah, you can hold off on it. It's fine.
Yeah, I know.
But Drake, owner of the Raptors, has a lot of money. Speaking of someone else that has a lot of money now, the world record. Well, no, okay, it's this dude named James Holzers. I think it's how you pronounce it. He was just shy of breaking the record for most earnings on Jeopardy. He won way too many games in a row.
It's kind of dumb. I'm like, okay, hear me out. I think it's cool as shit just to have a bunch of random trivia in your head. Like, for some reason that's an appealing thought to me. But just like trying to sell someone losing their Jeopardy streak to be interesting is so hard.
Well, I think it's interesting when you look at it through the term of how much money he's won through his, I believe, 33 game win streak.
Wait, okay, how much is that?
Just shy of 2.5 million dollars.
What the fuck? Can I just hit the rewind button on every word I just said, or what?
Yeah, no, you can go for it. But
Yeah, okay, so yeah, this guy's unfortunate. He almost broke the record for the show. Holy shit.
yeah, he won a lot of money and he holds like the record for most earnings in a single game, yada yada. And it's very like it's hard to make Jeopardy entertaining unless you're like 90, but I guess he brought the most viewership to Jeopardy in years. So he's been doing it. I guess this dude is like kind of, they literally whenever they describe him, he's just a gambler. Like that's his like job.
Huh.
A part of, he lives in Las Vegas, and I guess Las Vegas gave him a ceremonial key to the Las Vegas Strip, which I don't know what that would go to, but good for you, my man.
Huh.
I don't know.
Interesting.
He just wanna
That's
he wanna fuck a
yeah,
ton
he
of money.
fucking dominated Jeopardy.
Yeah.
Shit. Well, how the I always wonder, like, how do people like get so good at Jeopardy and just in general? Because there's such a wide range of topics. I wonder if it's just a very high base level of knowledge.
I think, well, yeah, I definitely think you just gotta memorize a lot of random facts, but I think people just watch the show a lot and they study the answers and stuff of that nature.
Liddy.
Lady, like a titty. I don't remember where I was.
So, I mean, essentially, this guy lost his Jeopardy streak, man. That kind of sucks. He was only 58,000 away from breaking this dude's record.
Yeah, but it seems like he wasn't too upset about it.
I mean, he definitely walked away with a bunch of money.
Yeah.
Do you know
Well.
how much you like earn per episode? Like, was he just shy by like one or two episodes or something?
Yeah, I think he was probably shy by 2 episodes.
He says during his streak he won an average of 77,000 per game. So, he was literally one episode off. Holy
Oh,
shit.
Jesus. But
That sucks.
he said, "Nobody likes to lose, but I'm very proud of how I did, and I really exceeded my own expectations for the show, so I don't feel bad about it." So that's good. Very, I'd say
That's
optimistic
right.
way to be about it.
I agree. I agree.
So.
I actually really agree with that. I expected he would be a little bit more salty.
I probably
So,
would be.
this isn't news, but do you know what's really weird to think about or kind of wild to think about?
Hit me.
Like back in the day, they did a lot of not up to code medical things to like solve ailments and shit. And I saw this because there was an old first aid kit from, I believe, 1850 something, or just a medical bag. You know what was in it?
What?
Tubes of cocaine and heroin.
Oh yeah.
And this was a first aid kit.
I mean, it definitely help you out in some way, shape, or form, but probably not the way you're looking for.
I mean, but could you imagine going to the doctors like, "Oh, doc, I've had this really bad cough." You've been down the mines for 12-hour shifts. You barely know what your kid looks like at this point. You just want to get rid of your cough, and the doctor's like, "Ah, here's this white powder. Just snort it, and it'll be fine."
Yeah, why not?
Like,
Like,
they gave it to kids, apparently.
well, it's definitely times have changed, and we found better alternatives to cocaine, believe it or
Like
not.
essential oils, yeah.
Yeah, like nowadays you could get your kid a shot to prevent the flu, but I'm sure Jesus and my essential oils probably do a better job. That's just
Of
how we've
course.
advanced as a nation, you know?
But like, it's so weird to think about like genuinely how fucked you could have gotten. Like, I don't know, like the purity levels of old cocaine was like, but how long do you think it took them to make a connection? Like, all right, yeah, maybe they're saying their symptoms are, better because they're so high they can't even feel them anymore.
I mean, that's probably why it's not, or that's why it's illegal at this point.
I don't know, like cocaine and cough syrup, man, that's so weird.
Yeah. Well, it's simply, like I said, we just keep bettering and bettering in the. It's always, I don't know, there's a lot of instances like that where I can't believe we used this instead of this.
Can you think of a couple?
I can think of a lot for sports, but it's just because it wasn't advanced at the time. Like basketball was a peach basket and like a fucking rock.
That's true. That's true.
Baseball rock and stick. I don't know anything of that nature, really.
I know like there was like lobotomies I know were pretty freaking wild that they thought worked. Like that's when they like essentially just drained blood from you or
I
from your
thought.
head or like they insert tubes into your brain and shit.
Yeah, I thought lobotomies are just like really scuffed brain operations.
No, they thought they cured mental illness.
Oh yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Like, that's crazy. They thought that by inserting various objects in your head, it could cure your depression.
Or just
your
taking,
anxiety or your schizophrenia or whatever. Yeah.
Or just taking some chunks out of your brain they thought it would fix. Like, they thought certain aspects of the brain is where, like, mental illness was stored, and they just pluck it out.
Shit. They thought bloodletting was a good thing, where they just let themselves bleed.
Yeah, fuck it, man.
Why?
Well, I mean, all right, if you think about it, they are technically fixing your issue. They might be causing another issue, but technically they're doing their job.
I mean, is that other issue death?
Just suffering. Nothing bad.
just suffering. Give him some cocaine. He won't even tell the holes there.
Yeah. All right. Like, I'm just imagining, like, an operation, like, they're doing a lobotomy, like, instead of, like, surgically taking your scalp off and knocking you out, like, you're awake, and they just took, like, a hammer and just bashed just their skull clean in half, and they're like, can you give me that metal pointy thing over there?
Like, honestly, what could they be thinking? Like, you go into the doctor, like, hey, doc, I've been feeling pretty down lately, man. And it's just, there's, like, this voice in my head that's telling me to do things that I don't want to do. And, you know, the doctor runs like, fetch me my chisel, and brings out the sledgehammer out from under the desk. All right, this is going to hurt a little bit, but I'm going to put a hole in your head. And you should be good.
I like how you're just Kermit with an accent there for a second. But
that's crazy that people would actually be like, yeah, a hole in my head could help me out here.
Yeah. I mean, granted, this is a long time ago, but it's also the fact that we were stupid enough to think, like, oh, yeah, this is good. This is fine.
Well, exactly. Like, who would, did the people that came out of the operation alive just be like, yeah, you know, I recommend going to get a hole in your head. It really helped me out.
As they say that with their fucking slack jaw, tongue hanging out, eyes drooped down below their chin.
Like, for real, like, unless these people, like, I don't think they're coming out fully fine. Like, some of these fuckers probably don't even remember yesterday because of it, you know? Like,
I'm saying they probably don't remember a lot more than just yesterday. They come out looking like ugly dolls.
For real, like, did no doctor actually, like, take up this surgery himself and was just like, hey, by the way, this does not feel good. You shouldn't do this.
I get you. Yeah, I'm wondering how they, like, figured out, like, oh, this is bad. We shouldn't do this.
Yeah, well, for real, I'm just curious to, like, I imagine it started off by, like, very primitive, like, medicine where, like, you'd go, like, a sage or, like, a medicine man that was considered, like, a wizard, and they got a little kooky, and they're like, you need a hole in your head.
Yeah.
And the person's like, well, if it'll save my wife, do it.
Or do you think, like, when shit like this was coming to an end, it happened because, like, a doctor needed surgery, and they're like, oh, lobotomy's 100% success rate so far, and then they did it on him, and he's like, guys, we gotta switch it up.
Yeah, for real, like, did no one just believe anybody, like, afterwards? Like, I just can't imagine, like, a lobotomy would have a good track record, I guess.
Hey, doc, I don't know who I am anymore. It's fine. Just take some coke, you'll be better in the morning.
Yeah, for real. Gosh, could you imagine? Like, oh, doc, I got a really bad runny nose. Put some coke up there.
It's like, that'll fix it. Yep. Might lead to other issues, but who's to say?
My goodness. Like, I wonder if the life expectancy was so low is because they were dosing themselves with cocaine from a young age.
Oh, yeah, I mean, we're basically killing ourselves.
Jeez. Do you think, like, pregnant women were was prescribed cocaine? Like, I'm probably, like, gravely embellishing the actual use of, like, cocaine medically, but still. Like, do you think they gave it to, like, pregnant women at first and shit?
You know, honestly, I'm not sure. I'm just kind of going on your word with all of this.
I just think it's wild to think about.
Yeah. No, I agree. Definitely a little, little kooky bonkers, as some of the kids say.
For real. Man, could you imagine if, like, I mean, we're doing it now with, like, opioids. We're now, like, turning around and being like, wait a minute, we shouldn't be fucking using these. You know, so I guess it's, like, kind of the same thing. I guess, you know, we're not as advanced as we thought, right?
Yeah, I guess so. Well, that's the thing, is, like, we're always going to be evolving, whether we realize it or not. Like, we're going to start
a century. Yeah, exactly. Evolving.
Yeah. Or at least doing, like, our best.
Yeah, like, a century from now, like, I don't know, they could look back on us and be like, ha, those peasants used cough drops to help with their coughs? Idiots.
Yeah, honey, fetch me my anti-cough robot.
Yeah, for real. Okay. Gosh, well, where do you think your cutoff would be for, like, too advanced medical tech to really be, like, okay with it with your current mindset? Like, what if a new medical tech came out, like, tomorrow, but it was completely bizarre? Would you still do it?
Depends how extreme. I'd say...
Okay, to get rid of your cold, they have to go in through your butt and essentially give you a prostate exam, but for, like, an overnight thing.
I don't even know how that would work. Probably wouldn't be on board if they're giving me a prostate exam to check my cough. But if it's something that'll, like, save my life or improve my life vastly, then, yeah, sure, why not?
Interesting. Well, I'm wondering, like, who, like, I always kind of thought that the new medical science is interesting because, like, who gets to decide if something's ready to be tested on people, like, for new medical practices and stuff?
I mean, normally when, because I don't know if they still do this, but I know, like, they test on, like, rats and shit of that nature.
Okay, I guess that's fair, yeah.
I mean, there's definitely, like, enough testing to go on to where it's...
Mm.
They should know it's, like, available to be used.
Mm. Well, okay, for the future, yes. I was thinking more, like, for in the past as well, to keep going with our discussion. Like, when were they like, yes, let's move on beyond holes in the head? Like, I'm just thinking, like, how freaky that would be. Like, were they just like, any volunteers? I need to try out something new medically. But that new medical thing is just literally, like, a bigger tube in the head instead?
Oh, probably, yeah. Or they just, like, say someone had something wrong with them, they're like, oh, let's try this one out instead.
Yeah, or, like, doc, there's something wrong with my back, so they, like, attach, like, their legs and arms to a stretcher and, like, try and roll them out or something, like... Was there human trials like this before there was, like, a regulatory system?
I imagine, yeah.
It's kind of bizarre just to think about. I would just hate to live back in the day for all this shit. That's too many ailments. I would die early from a surgery related injury.
World's a scary place, I'd say.
Hell yeah, it is. All right. Jeez, that yawn signifies that we know what time it is. Yeah. I know what time it is. Do you know what time it is, Dan?
You can enlighten me.
It's time to say goodbye for the Frying Pan Podcast this week.
Mm-hmm.
And with that, folks, that has been the end of the Frying Pan Podcast, episode 31. We are nearing a third of the way to 100, which is pretty litty. And with that, we have social media. As you guys know, we have a Twitter and an Instagram. We'd appreciate if you give us a follow over there. We post on there semi-regularly-ish, mostly on the Instagram. And the handle for those is The Frying Pan Pod. And you're listening to us right now on either Podbean, Spotify, Apple Music, Stitcher, or YouTube. So thanks for doing that. We appreciate it. And if you could go the extra mile for us and give us a star rating, leave us a like, that'd be sweet. And if you could go through the extra effort of leaving a comment, any form of constructive criticism helps. As I always say, we do this to get better. So it'd be great to have some input from you guys. And on that final note, once again, this has been the Frying Pan Podcast. Have a great rest of your week. Have a great rest of your day. Have a good one, folks. I've been Robert D'Onofrio.
Me also, Robert.
And we've been Robert. See you later, alligators.
In a while, crocodiles.